Hey everybody, thanks for joining us today. Flying with Big Earn, we're gonna do something a little bit different. I've been meaning to put these types of videos out for a little bit now. Just kind of a question and answer if I get some questions, you know, on the road or just through some friends or, you know, through the comment section down below, I'd like to try to get those out. But one of the most common questions that I've received so far is what my opinion of the airline industry is as far as moving forward in the future. Mike S., thanks for the comment down below. He asked that question, as well as whether or not I felt starting pilot training would be a good idea or not a good idea with the current environment. So let's attack the first question and on what I feel personally the future of the airline industry is. Now, before I start, I just want to make sure that I am not representing my company at all or anybody else. This is just my opinion, kind of moving forward. The future of the airline industry, man, that's a good question. I am always bullish on the airlines just because I think people, human beings, just naturally want to go out and explore. I mean, that's just humans, human nature. Whether they take a car, an RV, a boat, or a plane, I think we as humans just want to get out there and explore and interact with other human beings. And I think this virus has really challenged us with that. I think being cooped up at home has really just drove a lot of people mad as far as, you know, not being able to interact with people, not being able to go out and take a look at the Grand Canyon or go to Paris or, you know, go to the Hawaiian Islands. It's been a challenge lately. So I think the future of the airline industry will always be that people will want to get out and fly and go travel. So with that, the challenge for us is obvious. You know, how are we going to defeat this virus? I think once we have a handle on the virus as far as testing goes, as far as a treatment plan, and especially a vaccine, I think you'll see the airlines start to move quite aggressively, in my opinion, in that direction as far as growing, as far as getting back to pre-virus levels. That's my opinion on that part. What's the timeline? I have no idea. You know, I like to keep up with the financials and see what's happening out there financially, just, you know, for my own investing purposes, which is a good spot to track if you're really looking at this virus and trying to come up with a timetable. They don't know either, but it's interesting to kind of see their perspectives and just get a broad range of ideas and perspectives from people. But what I feel as me sitting in this position, I think it's going to take probably a year or two before we really get a handle on this virus. And after that, getting the flying public comfortable with getting on an airplane. I think my company and a lot of companies have done a great job of really highlighting what they're doing as far as disinfecting the airplanes and keeping them safe for our passengers to get on and go somewhere. And I think that's just going to continue in the future. It's definitely going to help with the common flu and those ailments too. So I think flying airplanes is probably going to be a lot cleaner than getting into your own car and driving places. So that's my opinion. I really pray and hope that we do find a vaccine and a treatment plan and we get testing and all that stuff runs really well. That's going to be the key to making sure that our future in the airline industry is saved, because right now, you know, a lot of CEOs are talking about downsizing their airline and becoming smaller airlines than they were. That's a scary thought. You know, I've got friends at all the airlines, so yeah, it's competition and we're competitors, but at the same time, they're my buddies, they're my friends. I don't want to see them and suffer as well. So I think us getting a vaccine and, you know, moving along that way, it's going to help everybody. And we'll hopefully all get back to business of teasing each other on the radio and doing banter back and forth. But I hope that answered the question. Bottom line is, it's anybody's guess. They're ranging anywhere from, you know, next year to 4 years from now. So who knows? Let's just control what we can control, you know, and we'll let... you know, we got smart people out there working on this stuff. So let's just keep them in our thoughts and prayers, and hopefully we'll get a solution to this really soon. Okay. Next one is whether or not I still think right now is a good time to start in flight school and get your license and move on towards a career. I'm guessing it's a career in the airlines. I'll approach it from just getting your private pilot license just to fly for fun. Yes, do it. If you have the means and you can still go and find a flight school right now, because honestly, the flight schools are pretty busy. But if you can, and you just want to get your private license, just see what it's all about, absolutely do that. Do that right now, you know, while you can and while there's opportunity. Flying has been an absolute passion of mine. I love flying anything. If it has wings and an engine, I want to check it out and see what it's like. So that would be my recommendation. Now, if you're asking from the second part of whether or not you want to make it a career and go into the airlines, it depends. It depends on whether or not you can wait, because it may be a while before you get to that airline job, that first airline job, meaning the regional airlines. Right now, a lot of people are losing their jobs at the regional level, so they're going to be the first ones to go back to getting some of those jobs because they're trained, they have type rating. It'll be easier to bring them up to speed rather than take a new person and train them all over again. So just know that it's not going to be the, hey, I've got my 1,500 hours, where's my job? I think those days are going to be at least slid a little bit, a couple of years. So what that means is you're going to be spending a lot more time flight instructing or banner towing or sightseeing or, you know, whatever the myriad of jobs are, you know, having a charter job, flying charter. That's okay. You know, approach it with a good attitude and learn as much as you can at each stage that you're at. And I think you'll be successful. The other thing about that is developing relationships along the way. You never know who you are going to meet that is going to impact your life down the road. So treat everybody with respect. You know, that goes without saying. That's just being a good person. But and developing those relationships. You know, if you can help somebody out now, yeah, do it. You know, that person may be able to help you out down the road. And not that you're entering into that relationship because of that, but just by being a good person, you know, I've called up several of my friends and said, hey, man, you know, what are you doing? Because they've called me up before and asked, hey, do you need a job? I know you just moved back to Arizona. And yeah, I sure do, man. This aviation industry is a small world. Have a great attitude, treat everybody with respect, and you will be successful in that. Timing-wise, who knows? We have no idea when this whole thing is going to be over and what opportunities lay ahead. But that's the other flip side of that coin is you have no idea what opportunities are ahead. So are you willing to take that chance? Are you willing to get out there and hustle and prove that you want to be in this industry? Because those are the people that are going to make it in this industry. When things get tough, they find a way. That is my opinion on that. And I am putting my money where my mouth is. My daughter is currently taking a check ride as of right now on her commercial. So keep my fingers crossed for her. But I'm telling her, keep pressing ahead. Keep getting those ratings. Keep learning as much as you can. And don't stop. Just keep going. You've made it this far. Let's keep going. So, all right. I hope that helped. I hope everybody is staying safe out there. I hope you guys liked the video. If you did, you know, smash the like button, subscribe, comment down below. Let me know what you want to see next. What topics you have, what questions you have. I'll try to do this, you know, once every couple of weeks if we get enough interest, maybe once a week on top of the other videos that I put out. But I appreciate your guys' support. Thanks for the love and support that you guys are putting on the comments and liking. I really do appreciate that. This video was basically made to answer questions that you guys had, and I hoped it helped. So, Mike, thanks for the question. We'll take care, and we'll talk to you guys soon.